Okay, talking about social network and Web 2.0, I would like to talk to you about several tools available out there. And one of them, just like I mentioned in the previous video, was Wix.com. Just create your account and you would be taken to this page. Okay, just as a heads up, I will be covering an entire video in which I would explain later, once I'm done with the overview, I would come back to the site and create a complete website from scratch for you and give you an idea how you can get started on your e-commerce website. But you need to have all the concepts that we covered, all the technology and the terminologies covered in the course, you need to be able to apply them. Moving on to the next slide, we have the social networking service, or SNS, and I'm pretty sure everybody knows what that is about. It's a service that builds online communities by providing an online space for people to build free home pages, and that provides basic communication and support tools for conducting different activities in the social network. Okay, LinkedIn, Twitter, Facebook, all of these are social networking communities. And also in your web page, you may have a blog page, you may have a community support page. These are all social networking sites. Okay, they enable people from different backgrounds to meet under one platform and talk about similar interests. Social networking is the creation or sponsoring of a social network service, and any activities such as blogging done in a social network, or external or internal. Okay, once you have an electronic website, an e-commerce website or e-business website up and running, you may want to always add a blog page. Now, a blog page is a page where you share your latest discoveries, research, or any kind of observations or perceptions you may have about your product or your service, any kind of community responses that you need to make. You can add that in your blog page. If you have a flair for writing, that's fantastic. Just create your own blogs and inform the community what you're up to at this particular point. What this does for your online consumer is that it helps build trust. It helps build affinity. They like you and they like what you're doing, and they want to learn more about you and they want to invest their money in you. So this is something that you really want to do, and we're going to talk about this more once I am in the hands-on part of this course, where I would be explaining what the do's and don'ts of successful e-commerce website. Enterprise social networks or social commerce, the e-commerce activities conducted in social networks or using social software, Web 2.0 tools. I just explained that. So this is just like, you know, repeating the same definition again. Then we have virtual worlds and Second Life. Okay, this is also a very fast growing and up and coming field in e-commerce, the Second Life or virtual worlds. A virtual world is a user-defined world in which people can interact, play, and do business. The most publicized virtual world is Second Life. We can just explore Second Life right now to let you have an idea of what this is about. Second Life. What this is about is that you create your own world with the help of your own language, and you can play for free. You create your own icon that represents you. You can also use latest technologies to experience the latest apps developed for Second Life, and all you do is you just interact inside this online virtual world and you buy things. This is not just for amusement, this is for gaming, and also purchase. You can purchase many options. Sometimes these purchase products are only for the virtual world. Sometimes they're delivered at your doorstep. So this is also one of the ways of capturing more audiences. For example, there are plenty of people who are addicted to the internet, who have literally a second life in the internet. So for those people, for that target population, they have created e-commerce solutions to enable them to purchase things online and use them. So the other one here is how. Okay, so a lot of people end up making a lot of money in the virtual world because they feed on other people's, you know, passion, and they want to be able to provide them with a service while they are in this virtual world. Then the major tools of Web 2.0, again, wikis, RSS feeds, blogs and microblogs, example Twitter. Okay, we're going to cover that more in the upcoming chapter. Okay, the digital economy is an economy that is based, the digital world, economy, enterprises and society. In this section, we cover the digital economy, which is an economy that is based on digital technologies, including digital communication networks, computers, software and other related information. Technologies, information technologies, also called the internet economy, the new economy or the web economy. Okay, so we can see a paradigm shift from a traditional method of, you know, running and functioning an economy to a web economy. We can see that around us very quickly. Electronic commerce is invading all areas and all facets of business communities. Okay, a digital enterprise is a new business model that uses IT in a fundamental way to accomplish one or more of the three basic objectives. Number one, reach and engage customers more effectively. Okay. Number two, boost employee productivity. Number three, improve operating efficiency. Okay. So these three things, if you are covering in your business using internet and the IT technologies, you are a digital enterprise. How? Because how do you reach and engage customers? By providing your blog pages. I just explained that. You provide blogs and information on your product and service, and you engage your customers in a deeper manner. You encourage them to ask you questions, and you answer questions. Not only you answer questions as a site mentor, you engage other members of the participating members of this community to answer questions. So you engage the customer. Okay, you have technical experts that have their biodata published on the website, and people know who they are talking to and what kind of information they can get from them. So if you are engaging with your customers in this way, you are a digital enterprise. Secondly, if you boost employee productivity, for example, you benchmark with the best going on out there, your competitors, how they're doing it, you benchmark it. You purchase the latest e-learning training or professional development courses, and you make them available for free and make it mandatory for your employees to practice on. So these are the, if you do that digitally within your electronic commerce community, within your whole environment, business environment, you are a digital enterprise. Lastly, you improve operating efficiency. Operating efficiency could be the way your factory or your manufacturing units are working, the way your employees, how efficient they are working, how efficient transactions are going on. So any kind of operations, to improve operations efficiency, if you're doing that through the digital or technology solutions, you are a digital enterprise. Okay, my goal for this course is to help you become a digital enterprise eventually. Okay, so you start with the fundamentals, okay, an IT infrastructure fundamental, and then you apply a layer of business terminologies, business concepts, e-business concepts, and then another layer of marketing. And then what you have here is, you know, with regular updating, you have a nice, functionable, successful e-commerce website. That's what my goal is. And within this website, you have three of these objectives covered. Okay, the way you reach and engage. Okay, number one, reach and engage customers. Again, number two, how you boost your employees to be more productive, and how you improve the operations of your business. Okay, now another aspect of an e-commerce website. Let me tell this to you now at the very beginning of this course, is that any e-commerce website has several portals. Okay, portals means several views available. There's a corporate portal, which is a view specially for the employees of that company. There's a public portal so that you and I can see the same things on that page. Then there is an operations portal in which, you know, the people, they only, it's like a back end. And those employees that are working in operations, for example, logistics, procurement, and all the back-end employees, they update the information in that section of the website. So you have a different portal in one e-commerce website. You have to be able to appreciate that the view that you are seeing is just one of the views. Okay, it's like an intranet and connected by one extranet. Okay, you need to be able to understand that. A major gateway through which employees, businesses, partners, and public can enter a corporate website. Okay, so there's several gateways to an e-commerce website. We're going to talk about that more in detail. Okay, the digital society is a changing business environment. Okay, performance, business pressures, and organizational responses, and electronic commerce support. So the digital economy or the digital society is going through a lot of changes. The business environment and performance impact model is changing. Business pressures are changing. Organizational response strategies are changing. Okay, and there are a lot of strategies that support electronic commerce, and the major capabilities of electronic commerce are changing. Okay, let's look at this diagram. This is the business environment and performance model in a digital society. Okay, supposing this is your company. Okay, you have mission, goals, and strategy plans. You have problems, pressures, and opportunities. You have an actual measurable performance. That's called key performance indicator or KPIs. Okay, I'm not going to go into deep business terminologies here. I am only going to integrate how IT is integrated with business to create an e-business. That's what essentially we're going to be talking about right now. Our company, in your company, you have business processes, core competencies, critical responses, activities, and solutions. Okay, so electronic commerce and IT support infrastructure and applications, this is what you have. Okay, you have a complete infrastructure of LAN, WAN, MAN, that's the networking protocols. You have the, you know, the cabling and everything and the hardware. Then you have a software layer in which you have for example, Wix.com, WordPress, Joomla. There are many software available to run your website. Then you have back-end software, front-end software. Then you have content of your website. You have databases on your website. You have missions, you have problems, you have performances. And then this is the business environment. So just try to visualize your own e-commerce solution, your own business plan within this diagram. Okay? Let's look at this diagram. How does the major capabilities that contribute to the electronic commerce growth? Okay, so my dear students, when you design your own website, I want you to keep this diagram in mind. Okay, your goal is to experience growth. Okay, how can you experience growth? You need to be able to provide anytime, anywhere convenience to your customer. Okay, which means that your website should be device friendly. Okay, if the customer is experiencing the website through the mobile, it should be mobile friendly. Your website should be mobile friendly. Again, the IT inferences in this point is that, you know, you should be able to provide an HTML5 site which shows up very nicely in a tablet, in a smartphone, anywhere. Okay, so these are the things. That's the first thing that you need to remember. Easy to find product or vendor information. You should have a very good search tool in your website. Just take a look at this website here. One of my favorite, it's called Marka VIP. This is one of my favorite two e-business websites. Okay, I'm already a member here. I already have 7 items in my bag. And what I'm trying to say here is that what you need to do is, if I need to search for something, I don't want to look at their catalog. They have like thousands and thousands of items here. I just need to search for something. I would just put in shoes here. Okay, and it would come up with a lot of shoes, a lot of shoe ideas. Okay, and I would want to go for women's shoes and only show me ladies' shoes. And there are 163 pages to look at. Okay, and it would also refine my search so that I can only look for example, air soles. Okay, these are air sole shoes, only one brand. Okay, and I have sizes available here. What I'm trying to say here is that you should have a easy to find product or vendor information. Information should be very easy to find. Okay, and believe me, sites like these, the ones that I was showing, where is it? Wix.com. I think I deleted it. Yes, Wix.com. Sites like these would allow you to be able to create similar websites. Okay, I will show you. I will devote a video series to show you how to you can create your own website. Okay, just hang in there. Then you have a productivity booster, which means that you train your employees, whoever is running your website, whoever is responsible for customer service, customer support, or IT support. All of these people have the latest up-to-date trainings available to them. Okay, knowledge, advice, and collaboration. Okay, rich media, entertainment, social networking should be available to them. Knowledge, advice, collaboration, again, community of practice, rich media, entertainment, again, multimedia, enhanced website. Personalization and customization, again, take a look here. This is my own page. Okay, it says Zubia Mughal. It's my own page, and these are the things that I've seen in the past few hours, and they're also telling me to please take a look at our app. Okay, and hopefully this explains a lot. Price comparison for customers. They have sale markdown prices grayed out, and then they have dark prices. Fast dissemination of information. Okay, if I have a question, I send them an email. The turnaround is very quick. Within 2 hours, I get a response. What does this do? It increases my trust on the website. Efficient transactions, which means that I have, you know, whatever payment method I use, I get my receipts. I get my deductions clearly written. If there is a sale, if there is a promotion code that I apply, everything is very clearly done for me. Okay? Let's talk about this more in the next video. See you.